Good morning, all my dear students. So today we are going to do the leftover part from the lesson types of crop from geography, which we are doing from last 3-4 days. So as you can see in the picture, the name of the lesson is types of crop. It's from geography. So let's start. In the last class, as I already explained you about the cash crops, so let me do a bit of recap. So cash crops, also known as commercial crops, are grown for the sole purpose of selling the produce. They are not grown as a source of food, but mainly as raw materials for industries. The cash crops are considered to be very important because they play a vital role. It means an important role in our economy or in the economy of a country. They contribute to the foreign exchange. It means in important export businesses, and supply raw materials to different industries. Sugarcane, oil seeds, cotton, jute, tea, coffee and rubber are some important cash crops. They are mostly grown on plantation. Now in this class, I will explain you about sugarcane. In the last class, I already explained you about jute. So about sugarcane, what it is written here, that sugarcane is a tropical crop. It belongs to the grass family and is a main source of sugar. The temperature requirement for the growing of sugarcane is 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and about 125 centimeter of rainfall is required. It grows well in fertile, well-drained, loamy soil. Sugarcane is a nutrient exhausting crop, so adequate amount of chemical fertilizer have to be used in the field. It means for the cultivation of sugarcane, proper amount of chemical fertilizer is required in the field. It requires extensive manual labor as most of the work is done by hand. Sugar mills should be located close to the farm so that the canes are quickly transported before their juice dries. Now, most important thing is Brazil is a leading producer of sugarcane, following by India, Cuba, China and the United States. In India, sugarcane is grown in Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. So in this paragraph, we learned about sugarcane, which is a cash crop too. So it required a temperature between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and about 125 centimeter of rainfall. And it grows well in fertile, well-drained, loamy soil. It required adequate amount of chemical fertilizer too, and it requires extensive manual labor as most of the work is done by hand. Brazil is a leading producer of sugarcane, followed by India, Cuba, China and United States. In India, sugarcane is grown in Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Now about plantation crop. Plantation crops are also considered to be cash crops, such as tea, coffee and rubber are plantation crops. So let us go through tea. So about tea, it is written here that tea is one of the most popular beverage crops in the world, and it is a vital product of trade in the international market. It was first grown in China. Tea is grown in huge lands called estates. So the land where trees are grown extensively are known as estates. This crop requires high temperature and abundant rainfall for its growth. As you can see in our Assam, it is very much popular for tree plantation. So this crop requires high temperature and abundant rainfall for its growth. The plantations are normally found in the hilly slopes, as stagnant water is not good for tea plants. It is grown in the rainy tropical and humid subtropical regions like India, Sri Lanka, China, Japan, Indonesia and Kenya. China is the leading producer of tea in the world, followed by India. So in the right hand side of the picture, you can see there is a beautiful picture of a tea plantation in Tamil Nadu, India. Now about coffee. Coffee is an important beverage crop too. There are three varieties of coffee, Arabica, Robusta and Liberica. So these are the three varieties of coffee. Coffee is a highland crop of the tropics. It requires warm climate and moderate supply of moisture. After the berries are plucked, beans are dried, roasted, and ground into powder to prepare the beverage. The important coffee growing regions of the world are Brazil, Central America, Colombia, Sri Lanka, South India, and the Arabian Peninsula. Brazil is the leading producer of coffee in the world. The vast coffee growing regions in Brazil are known as fazendas. So the vast coffee growing regions in Brazil are known as fazendas. So in the left hand side of the picture, you can see a woman harvesting coffee on a plantation in Sao Paulo, Brazil. So with this, I am ending today's class here. Today in this class, we have learned about coffee and tea cultivation. I want you children to go through this paragraph, and if any doubt arises, you can ask me in the Google Classroom. Till then, thank you.